Ce qui vient le plus souvent à l'esprit quand on parle de la RDC, eh bien, ce sont...
What comes to mind when the country DRC is mentioned?
Eh bien, ce matin, je vous emmène à la découverte d'un projet qui a pour ambition de changer un peu...
However, I'm taking you on a journey to discover projects that changes the narrative about the Congolese people. Mama Africa is a series of photo portraits and testimonies of Congolese women produced by a British journalist of Spanish and Indian origin, Soraya Kishtwari, who has been living in the DRC for the past 3 years.
Des femmes qui, bien que souvent décrites comme les premières victimes de la guerre et des conflits, se révèlent finalement être de véritables résistantes.
The DRC is a country that for many foreigners who do not know the African continent remains impenetrable, sometimes exotic and little known. The only thing we know in general is that DR Congo is rich in mining resources. And the most informed know that these raw materials are at the heart of a war that has been going on for a long time. So knowing that the war is led by men and that women by extension are victims of this war, with Mama Congo, we want to show that women are much more than that. They are activists. They join their forces. They are actors of change, architects of peace, and so much more. So we do our best to break the stereotypes. But to do that, we must first raise awareness of the issues facing women in the DRC by focusing on our commonalities while underlining their diversity.
Tout en célébrant bien sûr leur diversité.
C'est une femme forte à qui a inspiré ce projet.
The Mama Congo project was inspired by a strong woman, a mother of five, Christine. Her life changed when her husband one day decided to marry a second wife and in the course of her refusal took away her five children, including her youngest, who she was still breastfeeding. Given the lack of support from her own family, Christine gave up. Soraya narrates the ordeal.
She was like a mother who had just lost her children, like a woman in mourning. And at the same time, her church was looking for someone to leave the capital and open an orphanage elsewhere. She did not hesitate. For her, it was the only way to move on. So this woman knew how to turn her grief into love for other children. And much later, with the orphanage already up and running for years, she also began working as a nanny. And with a salary, Christine was doing miracles. Unfortunately, Christine is not among the women interviewed by Mama Congo because she died far too young. She passed away on the 11th of March 2016, but she is the first inspiration for this book. Christine was not just an extraordinary Congolese woman, she was an extraordinary human being, period.
The portraits of Mama Congo will soon be published in a book to be released within the year. The girls from the orphanage launched by Christine in the coastal city of Mwanda will be among the first beneficiaries of this project. For more details on this, you can visit Mama Congo DRC on Facebook.
Mama Congo DRC, comme Democratic Republic of Congo. Toujours dans le même thème.
On the same issue, how can one find joy after experiencing indescribable trauma? This is the question sparked by a documentary, City of Joy, directed by Madeleine Gavin. The film focuses on a center created in 2011 in Eastern DRC by women's rights activist Christine Schuller, the American feminist Eve Ensler, and the most talked about man in recent times are fictionally called the woman repairer. He also doubles as the latest Nobel Peace Prize winner, Dr. Denis Mukwege. The refuge center, City of Joy, welcomes survivors of sexual violence often used as weapons of war. They stay there for 6 months and devote themselves entirely to their reconstruction.
La vision de la cité de la joie est de révolutionner la mentalité des femmes.
Each one of you is going to take center stage with your voice, with yourself.
Ça tout a transformé. Il est maté sur une autre mouli pata pour pouvoir bandugu.
Nilikuwa na boga sana tangia leo boga naisha.
I told my story. You can tell your story. There's a life after all we survived.
Depuis son ouverture,
since its opening, more than 1,100 women have left the City of Joy healed, autonomous and armed with new skills. I really encourage you to watch this movie. For those who can, it's been available on Netflix since September 7 because it shows that pain can be transformed into power and fuel to positive social revolution. Through this documentary, hope millions of people will be able to discover these Congolese women's journey and the immense work done by the City of Joy.